Hello, today we do the meaning guess game. 篮球，篮 means basket, 球 means ball. So 篮球 together, what's the meaning? Repeat after me first. 篮球，篮球，篮球，篮球，篮球。This meaning I think very easy to guess, right? 篮球 is basketball. Same as English, 篮球 is basketball. So next one, 足球，足球，计算，足球，球 is ball, 足 is foot, 足 is foot. About 足 you can remember in this way. This square you can think it's the knee, and under your knee you have the foot. Then you can remember this character in this way. It's the knee and the small, the how to say, the bottom part of leg, the small leg, and here the foot. This one in maybe 2,000 years ago, this character really means the small leg, but now only know means the meaning of a foot. You can remember in this way. 足 means foot, 球 means ball. So 足球 together, what's the meaning? 足球 together, what's the meaning? 足球 together, what's the meaning? 足球 is football, this one, football. And these two is the same as English, so it's very easy to know. And next one, 网球，网球，球 is ball. 网 is net. Do you think the Chinese character 网 is looks like net? You can think of the fishing net when you do fishing net, or some the spider net. You can think, you see the inside, this one, the inside looks like the inside the not the spider net, the web net. The web net also kind of sometimes drawing this picture and the fishing net. You see, Wang, the character looks like net. So Wang Qiu, what's the meaning? 网 is net, 球 is ball. So 网球 what's the meaning? Net ball. You think which sport have the net is very important. Can you know? 网球，网球，网球 is let's see the answer. The answer is tennis. Tennis. You think when you play tennis, the net in the middle is very important, right? So in Chinese, we call it as a net ball. 网球，网球，网球。好，next one. Next one. 羽毛球。This sport is very popular in China, but I don't know in other country. I don't know in your country, it's popular or not. 羽毛球。球 means ball. 羽毛 means the feather, the bird feather. Bird, you how to call the bird hair, the bird feather means the bird, the feathers. So 羽毛 means feather. So 羽毛球 what's the meaning? You think which ball you have a feather on it? Which ball you have feather on it? 羽毛球。羽毛球 is this one. Badminton. 羽毛球 is badminton. 羽毛 is feather. 球 is ball，羽毛球 is badminton。Because you can think the picture for badminton, they have a lot of feather, a lot of feather on it, right? 羽毛球 badminton，and 羽毛球 badminton。好，let's read one more time to review。篮球，篮球，篮球。足球，足球，足球，and 网球，计算，网球，网球，好，here，can you see this page? Here is this one. Let's see, this one. For example, football. Football is too easy. We just see the tennis. Tennis. This one? Tennis. We see the image, the picture. See? The tennis, why we call it as 网球? Because the net is very important. And the net, the picture, is similar to this Chinese character, right? 网球, you see? 网球, 对吧? Netball. And the 羽毛球, what is 羽毛? Let's search. 羽毛, this one, 羽毛. 羽毛 is this one, feather, 羽毛, you see? 羽毛 is feather. And you see, if you see the two feather, it's also a little bit looks like the Chinese character 羽. Do you think so? The Chinese character 羽 is looks like two feather. Not very same, but similar. Chinese character is similar to the picture. So you can use this way to remember the Chinese character. So 羽毛 means the feather. So 羽毛球 means feather ball. Let's see the result. 羽毛球, let's see. 羽毛球, but this is 羽毛. Why did it not change to 羽毛球? 这个, the internet is slow, not yet coming. 这个, 羽毛球, let's see this one. 羽毛球, the internet is slow, sorry. 这个, 羽毛球, maybe we search English, try. 羽毛球, this one. Later we see the picture. 羽毛球, feather ball, so it means badminton. 羽毛球, here, now it's coming. You see, the badminton is a ball with a lot of feather. So in Chinese, we call it as 羽毛球, badminton. And next one, 冰球. 冰球, you guess what's the meaning? 冰球. 冰球, 球 is ball, 球 is ball, 冰 is ice. So what's the meaning? 冰球, ice ball, what's the meaning? 冰球, I think in English is you say hockey, right? 冰球, let me check. 冰球, they also translate to P-U-C-K, what's that? I think translate to this one is better. Ice hockey, this one. 冰球, ice hockey. So 冰球, 冰 means ice, 球 means ball. So 冰球 is hockey, ice hockey. 冰球, 对吧? 冰球. And next one. Now is a 球. In Chinese, we have more balls. For example, 乒乓球. 乒乓球. 乒乓球 is the, in English, you also say 乒乓, right? 乒乓球, 好, we have more balls, but today we just gave you these five examples to show you the logic. We have more about this. And about the row. Row means meat. Row, this one, row. Row means meat. New means cattle. New means cow, cattle. So 牛肉 together, what's the meaning? 牛肉. 牛肉, 牛肉 the meaning is beef, because beef is the meat of cattle, the meat of cow, right? So 牛肉 is beef. 好, next one. 羊肉, yang is sheep, rou is meat. So 羊肉, what's the meaning? 羊肉, 羊肉 is mutton, 羊肉 is mutton. 肉 is meat, 羊 is sheep. 羊肉 is mutton. So, next one. 鸡肉, this one, 鸡肉. 鸡 is chicken, 肉 is meat. 鸡 is chicken, 肉 is meat. So, 鸡肉, what's the meaning? I think in English, 鸡肉 and 鸡 is the same thing. Chicken and chicken meat, in English, you say same word, I think. 鸡肉 is chicken meat, but in English you just say chicken. But here I write chicken meat to be clear. Chicken meat, so it's a 鸡肉，鸡肉，对吧？鸡肉。And next one, pork. Pork, do you know how to say? Pork. Pork. P-O-R-K, pork. Pork, how to say? Pork must have肉. So another character, how to say? Another character must be pig, right? Pig. Pig in Chinese, how to say? Pig, we say 猪, 猪, 猪. So 猪肉 is pork.So you see, all of the things, the same logic, same logic. 牛肉, beef. 羊肉, mutton. 鸡肉, chicken meat. 猪肉, pork. You see? And next one. Next one, we're talking about another system. Another system. This one, 电视. 电视, 电 means electricity.视 means vision, see, means vision, see. Well, this one, vision, vision, see. So electricity, see. You see something because have electricity. You use electricity to see the thing. What's that? What's that? It's a TV, television. Because television, you can think of, when the television is just the first time, first day have the television. When Chinese person see it, we think, oh, this one you can see a lot of things, but you buy the electricity to see it. So we call it as 电视, electricity see. 电视, electricity see. So it's the television. And the next one, 电脑, 电脑. 电 is electricity. 脑, 脑 what's the meaning? 脑 is brain, 脑 is brain.So electricity brain, what's the meaning? Electricity brain, you can use your imagination, what's the meaning? 电脑, 电脑 is a computer, computer. Because a computer is kind of, the computer can calculate, can do a lot of things. It's similar to a brain. They can have a picture, have video. Similar to a brain, they can store a lot of things. So this one, computer,For Chinese person, we think it's similar to brain, but use electricity. So we call it as 电脑, electricity brain. 好, next one related to 电. 这个电, 电 is electricity. 话, 话 is words, talk. Talk, you also can think it's words. Words. But electricity words, electricity talk, what's that?You think somebody talk with you by electricity. So it's a telephone. It's telephone. It's the traditional telephone. The telephone on the table. That one. 电话电话 If the this one, if you hold, oh, not this one. If you hold on your hand, this one, the mobile phone. In Chinese, how to say? The mobile phone, we say 手机手机 this one is use another system. 手 is hand. 机 is machine. 机 is machine. So 手机 means hand machine. So we call this one as hand machine. 手机手机 is cell phone. Is a mobile phone. 手机 So 电话 is electricity words. So it's a telephone. And the cell phone, mobile phone, we say 手机 hand machine. Hand machine.Similar to this one, the 鸡 the logic, we also have a lot of words. For example, this one. 洗衣机洗衣机这个洗衣 means laundry, means wash clothes. 洗衣 in English you can say laundry, but the literal meaning is wash clothes. Clothes. 哎呦, wash clothes. 这个洗衣 means wash, 衣 means clothes.So 机, 机 means machine, 机 means machine. So 洗衣机, wash clothes machine. So in English you say washing machine. This one. This is 洗衣机, 洗衣机, washing machine. And go on, continue the about 机, about 机. 这个机 is machine, 飞 is fly. 机 is machine. Fei is fly. Do you think the Chinese character Fei is a little bit looks like two wings is flying? Do you think so? I give you some picture about Fei. Feiji, you can guess what's the meaning. And now I'm talking about the character Fei. Fei, you see? 这个, for example, this one, this one, and this one, and but this one not read the whole thing, the emoji. So you see, this one and this one, they have two wings to fly. You see, looks similar to the Chinese character, right? So you can remember it this way. This one means two wings fly, so means Fei means fly, Fei means fly. So, 飞机 fly machine, what's the meaning? 飞机 fly machine, what's the meaning? So, it's an airplane. 飞, these two things are very cute. 飞, and the next one. 耳机. 机 is machine. 耳 is ear. 耳 is ear. 耳机 what's the meaning?耳机我自明年。耳这个耳 the Chinese character a little bit looks like the ear, right? How to say? Outside and the inside have a lot of, how to say? Like this, a lot of lines. So this is a little bit similar, do you think so? 耳 this one, this one? But this one, the inside not right, not a draw. If you draw the inside, it looks like this one.耳 means ear. So 耳机 what's the meaning? 耳机 is earphone, headphone. 耳机 And next one. This one is a little bit tricky. Because in Chinese, 机 the voice have another meaning. Different character. You see? So in Chinese, the 拼音 is not enough. You should learn some Chinese character. Because sometimes the 拼音 is same, but the character is different, and the meaning is different.For example, this G means chicken. This G is not machine. This G is chicken. Here. Before we also see it, where we see the row, you see? 鸡肉, chicken meat. So G's voice have two meaning. One means machine, one means chicken. So the different character have different meaning. So about the G, 这个鸡呀, G is chicken. And 母鸡This one, 母鸡 母 is female, 母 is female, female, how to write female, female, 母 is female, so 母鸡 what's the meaning? 母鸡 is a hen, right? In English, they like to make new words. A lot of things, they make new words. So when you learn English, you need to remember a lot of vocabulary.A lot of new words. But in Chinese, it's similar to block. It's similar to, you use some brick. This one, brick. Similar to you use some brick to make a wall. Use some block to make a wall. Understand? It's the thing, how to say, in Chinese we call it as 积木, huh?The building blocks, we call it as 积木, and building blocks, let's see, building blocks. 这个 Chinese thing is use the basic character to make a new word. So it's like use small meaning to make a bigger meaning. Similar to English, football, basketball.But in English, something like this is not much. In Chinese, a lot of things in this way. You see? Chinese, the thing is like the building block. You see? I think a lot of person, you play the 乐高, right? 乐高 is like Lego. 乐高 is like you use a small thing to build a bigger thing. So Chinese system is very like to use this way to do something. You see, this wall is kind of use bricks to make a wall. So Chinese, you see?In English, you just say female chicken as hen to make a new word. But Chinese is female chicken, use the block. You see, all of this is like this. 耳机, ear machine. 飞机, fly machine. 洗衣机, wash clothes machine. You see, this is a very important Chinese habit. And next one, for example, 火鸡，这个母鸡子恨哈，母鸡子恨。So how about 公鸡，计算公 and 鸡，鸡 is chicken, 公 is male.Oh, for animal, ha. In Chinese, 母 and 公 only for animal. Animal female, animal male. So, 公鸡 male chicken. So, how to say in English? 公鸡. 公鸡 is a, you say rooster, right? Rooster. So, you see, 恨 rooster is new words, but Chinese use building blocks. 母鸡公鸡母鸡 female chicken, 公鸡 male chicken, 母鸡公鸡 And another one is interesting. Another one is 火鸡，计算火鸡。鸡 is chicken, 火 is fire. You guess what's the meaning of 火鸡? You guess what's the meaning of 火鸡? And I see this person. How to read your name? Share with a model. You say, hello, Mr. Li Zhi. Hello. Not really hello. Maybe this character make me think out, how to say, hola or something, right? 好 hello. 这个, yeah, welcome you. In Chinese, we say, 欢迎你, welcome you.欢迎你。太平。这个 ,hello, can you hear me? Seems like an internet problem. now it's better. 欢迎你 is welcome you. 欢迎 is welcome, 你 is you. 欢迎你 welcome you. And 火鸡火 is fire, 鸡 is chicken. So what's the meaning of 火鸡? You can guess.I give you some time to type in the comments. What's the fire chicken mean in Chinese? It's one word. You see, 公鸡 male chicken means rooster. 母鸡 female chicken means hen. And 耳鸡, this 鸡 is another 鸡哈. This 鸡 means machine. 耳鸡 is ear machine, means earphone. 飞鸡 is fly machine, means airplane. So you use this logic, 火鸡 fire chicken, a chicken, looks like a chicken and have fire on it.So what's the meaning? Yeah, I gave you some time to write in the comments, and I use the time to teach you the character 火. 火 the character also is a picture. Chinese is not really a picture, but it's similar to a picture. For example, 火 is fire, see? The bottom you can think is firewood. Firewood. The bottom you can think is firewood. The top is fire flame. F-A-M-E, flame.So you see, the top part is flame, the bottom part is firewood. So together is this one, is fire, 火 is fire, right? 鸡 is chicken. And 鸡 the character also have the reason, huh? 鸡 the character, I think this one, the small dots, that's the eye of the bird. Because this one, 鸟 the character means the bird. You use your imagination, do you think this one is the, how to say, some birds have a hair on the top of head.And this is the eye, and this is the tail, this is the body, the tail, the eye, and the top on the bird, I don't know how to call that one. So this is 鸟, and 鸡 is one kind of bird, so we use this character. So you see, even the Chinese character is used the building block system, you see, building block. It's like use a brick to make a wall.The Chinese character 鸡 is used a part with the bird part to mean chicken, because chicken is one kind of bird. Also, the duck in Chinese we say 鸭子. This one is duck, D-U-C-K, duck. Duck is also one kind of bird. So you see, in the Chinese character, you can see the bird part. This one, 鸟 is bird. 鸟 is bird. 鸟.Yeah, it's bird. So about 鹅, Some of you, maybe you don't know what is 鹅 because some country didn't have this animal. 鹅 is goose. 鹅 is goose. 鹅 G-O-O-S, goose. 鹅 is goose. And 天鹅, 天 is sky, 哈。天鹅 is swan. 天鹅。天鹅。天鹅。天鹅 is swan. S-W-A-N. S-W-A-N is swan? 天鹅。天鹅。天鹅 is swan, 哈 ,swan. It's a very beautiful bird, fly.And 鹅 is usually they cannot fly very high. They just fly on the ground is okay. So 鹅 is goose. 天鹅 is swan. 鸭子 is duck. 鸡 is chicken. You see, all of them have the bird radical in the word. You see? Because all of them is bird. And also the eagle. Eagle we say 老. Eagle we say 老鹰哈。老鹰. That's right here. 老鹰. 老鹰 is eagle.老鹰老鹰 is eagle E-G-A-L How to write eagle、老鹰老鹰老鹰 is 计算 eagle 对吧老鹰 is eagle 这个鹰 you see 鹰 also have the bird radical can you see this thing? Let me make it bigger now it's bigger you see?老鹰 the character 鹰 also have the bird radical, 鸭子 bird radical, 鹅鸟鸟 is bird, 天鹅天鹅 is swan, you see? All of them have the bird radical in it. So this is the Chinese language. Chinese language is like to use building a new thing. So 火鸡 what's the meaning? Let's go on here. 火鸡火 is fire, 鸡 is chicken.So, 火鸡 is turkey, but not the country turkey. This one, Mongusta Turgus. Sorry, I'm not good at reading names. 欢迎你欢迎你欢迎你 is welcome you. 欢迎你欢迎你 And 火鸡 is turkey. It's not the turkey, the country. Ha. It's the turkey, the animal. Let's see. T-U-R-K-E-Y. This one, turkey.Turkey, this one. 火鸡 is turkey animal. 哈，你喜欢吃火鸡吗？你喜欢吃火鸡吗 ？It's a question. 哈 ，Oh, why this one internet is so slow? 好，你喜欢吃火鸡吗 ？It's a question. Can you understand? 你喜欢吃火鸡吗？你喜欢吃火鸡吗 ？It's a question for you. Can you understand?我没吃过火鸡，我没吃过火，哎呦，过一次装，我没吃过火鸡，我没吃过火鸡，我没吃过火鸡 ，I never ate 火鸡。我 miss me， 没 miss not， 吃 miss eat， 过 miss have done happen in the past。火鸡 miss turkey， miss the animal turkey。我没吃过火鸡，我没吃过火鸡。How about you?你喜欢吃火鸡吗？你喜欢吃火鸡吗 ？And hello from Turkey. Very interesting, very interesting. So now we are talking about Turkey, but not really about the country. The country Turkey in Chinese we say 土耳其，土耳其。You can repeat after me. 土耳其，土。I think 土耳其 is kind of voice translate. Do you think so?土哎呦 ，let's write 土耳其，土耳其 ，let's copy to where， 计算，好，计算，土耳其 ，where to write here 土耳其 ，yeah， 计算，土耳其哈，土耳其 is a voice translate because we read the。You see, this one is similar to Chinese 拼音 You see, Chinese 拼音是土耳其 And this one if you separate 土耳 This one is not 其 This is 其对吧土耳其 So this is a voice translate for the country 哈土耳其土耳其 And 火鸡 is for the animal turkey For the animal turkey 火 is fire 鸡 is chicken Because the turkey, the animal This is Turkey, the picture. Oh, this is about the country Turkey, huh? So how to see the animal Turkey? Turkey animal, A-N-I-M-A-L. Turkey animal, maybe you can find the picture. 这个, this one, very interesting. 这个火鸡, you see? 火鸡, it looks like a big chicken, super big chicken, and have fire on it. So we call it as 火鸡, fire chicken, 对吧? And 土耳其 is for the country, huh? But I don't know in English why the two words are the same. So maybe 土耳其 have a lot of 火鸡, the turkey animal. In your country, you have a lot of this. I don't know, because I never go to there. 这个计算, I never ate a turkey in Turkey. Really? Okay. I also never ate a turkey in China. In China, very few person eat a turkey. 我没吃过火鸡。我没吃过火鸡。 Yeah. Your sentence, I never ate a turkey in Turkey. Do you know how to translate this to Chinese? I never ate a turkey in Turkey. How to translate to Chinese? Do you know? 这个 how to translate? This one, we say 我在土耳其, you can say 在土耳其 first, huh? 在 in some place. 在土耳其 in Turkey, 对吧? 在土耳其 is in Turkey. And 在土耳其, 我没吃过火鸡, I never ate turkey, 对吧? Never, you also can say another way, but that way is more difficult, so we just learn the easy way. 在土耳其我没吃过火鸡, I have never ate turkey animal in Turkey, 对吧? 在土耳其我没吃过火鸡, 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 this is I never ate turkey in Turkey. 好, 这个 we continue the Chinese thing, huh? The Chinese thing. 这个 Chinese, a lot of words have a logical. And here is about the 鸡. We have a 鸡, we have 公, 母鸡, 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 公鸡, rooster, 火鸡, turkey. So how about other thing? Other thing about 牛, huh? About 牛. 这个牛, 牛, 牛 means cattle, and 公, 公 means male, 公 means male. So 公牛, what's the thing? 公牛, 公牛 in English, maybe you say this one, 不, about, this one. 公牛 in Chinese means male cattle. And 牛, I think maybe it's not really cattle. 牛 means in general, means all of the thing looks like the cow, looks like the cattle. In English, I don't know cattle is a general word or not. But in Chinese, this one is a general word. It's a general word. 牛 is a general word. 公牛 is male the thing, 对吧? Male the thing looks like a cattle. So 母牛, 母 is a, 母 have two meaning, huh? 母, one meaning is mother, one meaning is a female. Female. 母 used for person, you say 母亲. 母亲 is a formal way to say mother. But 母 used for animal means the animal female. Animal female. 这个, so 母牛, female cattle. So in English, I don't know in English how to say. Maybe you can say cow, but cow seems like usually they mean the milk cow. So 母牛 means female cattle. Not sure in English how to say. 母牛. And next one, 奶牛, 奶牛, 奶牛. 牛 is cattle, 奶 is milk. So 奶牛 means milk cow. Maybe you say dairy cow, milk cow. So 奶牛 is the milk cattle, milk cow, 奶牛. And go on. Go on is 牦牛. 这个牦牛, 牛 is the cattle. 毛, 毛 is the, means one kind of animal. And the half of it is 鸡丝毛, 鸡丝毛. 鸡丝毛 means animal hair, 毛. This meaning is animal, N-I-M-A-L, animal hair. The animal fur, animal hair. So 鸡丝牛 have a lot of hair, very long hair on the cattle. So do you know a cattle have very long hair? Do you know that one? And I see this one. You say no idea, 对吧? And with, oh, 欢迎你. Do you know 牦牛 what's the meaning? 牦牛. 这个牦牛, 牦 means hairy, how to say hairy, a lot of hair cattle. So what's the meaning? 牦牛. 牦牛 is in live in a very 这个 cold place. We talk about another one, and I give you some time to see to think what is 牦牛. Here we see 野牛. 这个野 means wild. 牛 means cattle. So 野牛. 野牛, I don't know in English how to say, but in Chinese means wild cattle. 野牛. 野牛 sometimes translate to this one, bison or bison. I don't know if it's correct or not. This uses the translate. 这个野牛, in Chinese, the meaning is very clear. 野 means wild, 牛 means cattle. So 野牛, wild cattle. You also can say 野鸡, wild chicken. 野羊, wild sheep. 野猪, wild pig. And you say 牦牛 is a house. Not really. 牛 is really the looks like a cattle, the thing, have the two horns. So 牦牛 is yak, huh? I don't know you know yak or not. Yak is in some very cold place, in Himalaya, right? In that place. So 牦牛 is yak. I see the picture, yak. 牦牛 is yak. This not horse. Horse is not really the same as this cattle. So 牦牛, huh? 牦牛 is yak. 这个毛的 character, I think just this one character also mean yak. Because it's how to say, it's have the 牛 the part. You see, the character have the 牛 the part. The left part of 毛, you see as 牛. So this is one kind of 牛, 对吧? 牦牛. And 野牛 is this one, bison. It's a wild cattle. 好, next one. 水牛. Some word like this, I'm not sure about the English word. 水牛, in Chinese we say it's water cattle. Some cattle they like to live in the water, they like to go in the water. I see the translation, my translation app, they say 水牛 is buffalo, but I'm not sure. 水牛 they translate to buffalo, huh? 这个, but not sure. So maybe we write it as water buffalo. Because it's why is it like this? Water buffalo, huh? 水牛. 这个水牛, so 水牛 is a water buffalo. This one, 水牛, water buffalo. 水牛. And 你见过水牛吗? 你见过水牛吗? In China, I have a lot of this. 你见过水牛吗? Water buffalo. 你见过水牛吗? 你见过水牛吗? Do you know the meaning? 你见过水牛吗? What's the meaning? 你见过水牛吗? 你 means you. 见 means see. 你 means you. 你 means you. 见 means see. 过 means have done something. 水 means water. 牛 means cattle. 水牛 water buffalo. 妈 is a question mark to make a question. So 你见过水牛吗? Means have you ever seen the water buffalo? 对吧? 你见过水牛吗? And we see next one. 黄牛. 黄牛, I also don't know the English translate. But 黄 in Chinese is a color, yellow. What about yellow? This one is yellow? Yellow. 这个牛 is cattle. So 黄牛 also very popular in China. It's a cattle and usually the skin, the fur, the hair is yellow. That one I don't know in English how to say. 黄牛, huh? 黄牛. And now we're talking about yang. 这个羊. Yang is sheep. Yang, I think yang is just a translate to sheep. Yang is just a translate to sheep. 绵羊. Mian cotton. Yeah, mian is kind of the fur is very soft. That one. So I think 绵羊 is a sheep, huh? 绵羊 together is a sheep. Yang is a general word. Yang means shape plus other thing looks like a shape, 对吧？I give you another example, can help you understand. 这个山羊 is mountain, 山 is hill, mountain. And the character 山 looks like mountain, right? 山 and the 山, you see? 山 looks like three hill, so it means mountain. And 山羊 mountain shape, what's that? 山羊 Yeah, good. Oh, I already see the answer.You say goat, very good, very good. 山羊 is goat. This one, goat. So you see, 羊 is not really sheep. 羊 is just a transit to sheep. I think 羊 should be shape plus goat. And plus everything looks like a sheep. So 羊 is a general word. So, 山羊 is mountain, the general word, so means goat. 绵羊 is the very soft fur, that animal, so it's a sheep. And the Chinese character 羊 is drawing the sheep. You think the sheep have two horns and have some mustache or something, 对吧？羊 the character is drawing the sheep, two horns.And the mustache, beard or something, right? So that's 羊哈。羊 is the general animal, cannot translate to English. And go on. So you also can say 公羊、母羊哈。母羊 means female sheep, 公羊 means male sheep. And now we're talking about another thing哈, about the 皮 skin, 对吧？皮is skin in general. 这个 for person skin, you can say 皮肤 For person's skin, you can say 皮肤皮肤 is for person skin. Sometimes you say 我的皮破了 my skin is broken. You also just say 皮 is okay. You say 皮肤 is more, is better for person, huh? For human. Not include human, all of other things, the outside thing, we call it as 皮I give you some example. 苹果皮 苹果 is apple. 苹果 is apple. 苹果皮 I'm not sure in English how to say. Maybe you can say apple skin. I'm not sure. Maybe you say apple peels or something. 苹果皮 in Chinese is just a logic. The logic is 苹果 with the outside thing. 对吧 Maybe you say apple skin. Maybe you say apple peel.But in Chinese, it's this one, 苹果皮 So other thing also can say in this way. For example, 西瓜 Do you know what 西瓜 mean? 西瓜 西瓜 is watermelon, 哈西瓜 is watermelon. So 西瓜皮 is a watermelon skin. In English, you have to say. In English, I see the Google Translate, they tell me it's a watermelon leather. I'm not sure, 哈这个西瓜皮 sometimes they translate to this one, watermelon rind. You see, in English, they make a lot of different words to mean the thing. But in Chinese, we like to find the common thing in the thing. We think 皮 is the something, the outside. Even the book, this one, the book, this page, the first page, you know how to say this one?Do you know the book, the first page, how to say? The book, the first page, do you know how to say? How to write? I don't know in English how to say. Is it book skin? S-K-I-N? Book skin? I think not to say book skin. 这个 you say cover, right? You say this one as cover. In Chinese, you call it as a,You just say 书皮 is okay. You say 书皮 is okay, 哈。书 means book. So 书皮 means book cover. You just change here to 书哈, this one. I write where? 这个皮 is skin. And 书 is book. 书 is book.So in Chinese, even this one, the book cover, we also say book skin， 对吧？书皮哈，书皮 book cover。这个 you have another way to say 封皮 ，but not important 啊。封皮是 another way to say the book cover 封皮。这个 so you see in Chinese we like to find the general thing 对吧？这个 这个 because I don't know how to read your name is Dogan Sirlik。You from Turkey, right? How about in your language? In your language, do you have the general word for the skin? In English, it seems like they not have. They have a rind, and they have peel, they have skin, they have leather, they have cover, they have a lot of different things. Because English like to make new words. Chinese like to make the general thing. They pick the general thing out, and later they use the building blocks.Building a wall, they use that method one by one to make a new word. So 书皮 means book cover, and 西瓜皮 means the watermelon rind, and 苹果皮 means apple peel. So this is the Chinese logic. And this one, you say cover page, and so we put something plus 皮 for something skin. Yeah, that's correct.That's the Chinese logic. And I see other thing. Cover page. Oh, in your language, you also have the dirty thing for skin, right? Yes, so our language is more similar. English language, I don't know for you, for me, English is very difficult because they have so much new words, so much new vocabulary. They not have The common thing is very few. And the next one, 土豆皮, this one, 土豆皮. 土豆, do you know the meaning? 皮 is skin. 土豆 is potato, 土豆 is potato. 这个豆 means bean, 土 means dirt. 土 means earth, dirt, D-I-R-T, dirt. 土 means dirt, 豆 means bean. So we call the potato as dirt bean because土豆 is a small round thing under the ground, have a lot of earth, a lot of dirt on it. So we call it as 土豆 potato. It's dirt bean. Huh? So you see, all of the Chinese is like a block to make it bigger, right? And 土豆皮, the potato skin, in English, I don't know how to say. 这个, and the next one, 红薯皮, 红薯皮. Do you know 红薯 what meaning? 红薯。皮 is skin, 红薯 红 is red, huh? So something is red, the skin is red. 红薯 is sweet potato. 红薯 is sweet potato. The English word sweet potato is logic, because it's maybe similar to potato, but have the taste is sweet. In Chinese, we use another logic. We say it's a red skin thing, 对吧？红薯皮。And in Africa, they like to eat 木薯。But I never eat it. Moon is wood. I don't know. Maybe it looks like wood and it looks like the sweet potato. In Africa, they like to eat this one, 木薯. I never eat. 我没吃过. I never eat. 红薯皮, sweet potato skin. So you see, in Chinese, all of the thing is in a logic. And this one.土豆 website. Oh, you mean the website to watch some movies? You mean that one? Yes. Before, I also like to use that website to how to say to watch some movies. And this one. This name also difficult to read. To yet bo mu. You say 你好 is hello, 对吧？你好，大家好。Do you know 大家好 what's the meaning?大家好 today I'm talking about the logic of a Chinese word, logic of a Chinese word, and logic of a Chinese word. If you learn some Chinese, can you give me some example of the Chinese word logical? The Chinese word is made by basic Chinese character. So if you learn some Chinese, if you know something, maybe you can give me some example about the Chinese logic. If you know something, you can write in the comment. And now we do the review. We do the reveal, huh? Do the reveal. Let's see. 篮球, you can repeat after me. 篮球, 篮球 is basketball. 篮 is basket, same as English. 足球, 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 足 means foot. 网球, 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 网球 means net. 网球, 网球。Which word do you like most? You can type your 姓。你最喜欢哪个词？你最喜欢哪个词？你 means you, 最 means most, 喜欢 means like, 哪个 means which one, 词 means word. Which word do you like most? You see, when we reveal, I will read all the words we learned today, and which one, which is the logic you like most, you can type in the comments, okay?网球 is netball, means tennis. 足球 football, 篮球 basketball. 好 continue. 羽毛球羽毛球羽毛球羽毛 means feather, 羽毛球 badminton. 冰球冰球冰球冰 means ice, 冰球 means ice hockey. 肉肉 means meat, 牛肉牛肉 beef, 牛肉 beef, 羊肉羊肉羊肉羊肉 is mutton, mutton, 羊 is sheep, 鸡肉鸡肉鸡肉 is chicken meat, chicken meat, 鸡肉猪肉猪肉猪 is pig, 猪 is pig, 电视 you can repeat after me to practice your tongues, because A lot of person think Chinese tongues is difficult because in your mother tongue, usually you didn't have tongues. So you repeat my voice to practice it, to make it better. So I read one word and give you some time to repeat. 猪肉猪肉电视电视 You can repeat after me.电视电视电视 And, you say don't see clearly. What do you mean? You mean on the screen it's not clearly? So I zoom it. I make it bigger. Now it's bigger. 好 continue. 电视电视 This one. 电脑电脑电脑电话电话电话脑 means brain, 话 means words, tell, talk, 视 means see, 视 means see. And continue. 手机手机手机洗衣机洗衣机洗衣机飞机飞机飞机耳机耳机耳机母鸡 This G and this G is different character, you see?This G is machine, this G is chicken. 母鸡母鸡母鸡公鸡公鸡公鸡火鸡火鸡火鸡公牛公牛公牛母牛母牛母牛奶牛奶牛奶牛毛牛毛牛 牦牛、野牛、野牛、野牛、水牛、水牛、水牛、黄牛、黄牛、黄牛、绵羊、绵羊、绵羊、山羊、山羊、山羊。And do you have some sentence or some Chinese word? You're not sure? Some Chinese question? You can ask me in the comments. For example, which word, which grammar, or which Chinese sentence, which sentence structure you feel confusing when you learn Chinese? You can type it in the comments. Later, I will answer you. 好, continue. 苹果, 苹果皮。苹果皮，苹果皮，西瓜皮，西瓜皮，西瓜皮，书皮，书皮，书皮，土豆皮，土豆皮。土豆皮，红薯皮，红薯皮，红薯皮。好 ，OK。好 ，Now let's see the comments. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comments about Chinese. Any grammar, any vocabulary, any sentence structure, you can write in the comments. I have a question. Why don't we say 肤皮 for human skin instead of 皮肤 It's an exception. Interesting, huh? 这个皮肤，皮肤 is one word. 皮肤 is same as 皮肤。这个肤呢 ，not 肤的 meaning already means skin. Because, for example, I give you some example 哈。For example, 护肤品，护肤品。这个 ，let's see where to write this one. 等等，好 ，let me write 护肤品哈。这个护肤品 is one kind of thing 哈 ，one kind of thing. A lot of girl.Like to buy it, 护肤品。这个护肤品，护肤品，护肤品，护肤品，对呢，怎么样？护肤品 ，Let's see. Right where? I change to here to write. 这个计算，好 ，change here to write. 护肤品，这个护肤品。Who means protect? Fu, this fu is wrong. I typed the wrong character. Sorry. 皮肤。这个护肤品的肤哈。护肤品的肤 means also means skin. So 皮 and 肤 both means skin, kind of. Understand? 护肤品。Let's see here. This one. 这个 skin care product. P-R-O-D-U-C-T. Product. Who means protect?Fu, just one character Fu already means skin. Fu usually means human skin, person skin. Pin means some products, some items, some products. P-O-U-C-T, some product. 护肤品 means skin care products, 护肤品。这个护肤品 Fu means skin. So in Chinese, 皮Usually mean the 皮 in general for everything, for apple peel, for animal skin, for all the things, we say 皮 And for person, we say 肤 And Chinese language like to say two characters, so we say 皮肤, 皮肤 If you separate them, also okay. You can say 我的皮破了 ，my skin is broken. Just say 皮 is okay. And you say 我在护肤 ，I'm a skin care. I'm doing skin care. I'm protect my skin. Both okay. 皮 and 肤 sometimes you can separate. You just sometimes use together because Chinese language like to say two character, like to say two character. I give you one example to help you understand. 桌子 do you know 桌子 what's the meaning? 桌子这个桌子 means table, and if you just say 桌 the meaning also means table. This one, 桌子这个 you just say 桌 already mean table, but a Chinese person likes to say two characters, so you say 桌子 to mean table. Now you understand this question, 这个why not say 肤皮 because 肤 the meaning not mean human, 肤 the meaning mean skin, mean human skin.If you no person says this, but if you really want to say the person's skin, you should say 人的皮肤人的皮肤 or you can say 人皮 but 人皮 sounds scary, not good. 人皮 means person's skin, but sounds scary. It's very scary. 这个 you just say 人的皮肤 is better, 哈人的皮肤人的皮肤对吧好 this is the reason, 哈这个 andWays say, 欢迎你欢迎你我最喜欢网球因为我打网球哈哈哈 very good. 这个 and hello, do you know how to say? 这个 F-E-F-E-F, you say, can you speak English? yeah, 这个 you can see the translation. And hello in Chinese, we say 你好哈你好。这个计算因为我打网球所以我喜欢网球。Very good. 也因为 is because, 所以 is so. 因为我打网球 because I play tennis, 所以我喜欢网球 so I like tennis. Good. 这个计算 I think I understand it's a special word. 好这个 and what clock in Mandarin?What clock in Mandarin? What do you mean? What clock? You mean what time? What time, right? What time in Chinese we say 几点了几点了这个 let's write here. 几点了几点了 means which time, what o'clock, which time, what o'clock. 几点了几点了 Oh, before I say you have a what a question about Chinese,Oh, no person answered me. Seems like all of you know, you're not confused about the Chinese grammar, right? Yeah, Chinese grammar is easy. 中文的语法不难 right? 中文的语法不难 right? 中文的语法不难 So I say you have any question about the Chinese grammar and nobody answered me because all of you think 中文的语法不难 right? 中文的语法不难 Do you know the meaning?中文 is Chinese, 的 means possession, 语法 means 这个 how to say, 语法 in Chinese literally means is language method, so in English you say grammar, 中文的语法不 means not, 难 means hard, difficult, 中文的语法不难 right? I think all of you think 中文的语法不难 so no person have question about 语法 and we see next one, what clock?What o'clock? 这个 means 几点了 And 你好 Yeah, 你好你好欢迎你欢迎你欢迎你 Welcome you And now we do some conversation, huh? Now we do some conversation 这个 first sentence 你是哪国人你是哪国人 You can answer me 你是哪国人 Do you know the meaning?你是哪国人你是哪国人 If you understand me, you can type the answer in the comments. 你 Let me type 是哪国人 Which sentence you want to learn, you also can type in it, and I will translate it for you.你是哪国人 What's the meaning? Do you know? 你是哪国人 This one 你是哪国人？好，Let's see，你，Miss you，是，Miss are，是 not really me are，是 Miss I'm is are，对吧？To be，哪 Miss which，W H I C H which，国 Miss country state，country，人 Miss person people，对吧？Person and people have an interesting story 哈，这个 just 10 days ago I don't know the difference of person and people, so I make a sentence like this. 他是美国人，you see? We say 我是美国人，对吧？And 10 days ago I make some shots. I say 他是美国人，他是美国人，计 算 interesting 哈，他是美国人，这个他是美国人，but when I make the translation. I say, where? I say in this way. I say, he is, May is nice, May is beautiful. 哈，美国 together means USA. 美国 together means USA. 这个人呢？Because I use the Google Translate translate to people, and I don't know the difference between people and person, so I just use this one to make some shots. Maybe some of you watch the shots. And a lot of person leave comments for me. They say, "Oh, you cannot say 'he' is people. People is for a lot of person. That people is for in general a lot of person." And that's the first time I know the difference. So English is very difficult. A lot of things need to learn. Right? 这个人，对吧？他是美国人。他是美国人。You should say person，对吧？他是美国人。And 你是哪国人？你是哪国人？这个 and I see，计算你是哪国人？You can answer me if you don't know the Chinese. You can say English. 你是哪国人？You can write your country name in the comments, and I will tell you how to say it. If only there was more Vietnamese, I can understand more. Really, your English not very good, right? You mean your English not very good, so you only see the English translation, you cannot understand. This is your meaning. But I heard that in I don't know how to read that one, Vietnamese. I heard that in Vietnamese you have some words, the voice is similar to Chinese, right? I think I have that one. 这个 because I don't know that language, so I cannot translate to that language. 这个 and here. 哇，thank you。啊，不客气，不客气，不客气。Do you know the meaning？不客气，不客气 means you are welcome 哈。也不客气，I think a lot of you know the meaning。不客气 is you are welcome。But do you know why？Why 不客气 is you are welcome？Because 不 in Chinese means not no。So why this one is you are welcome？You know the meaning？You know the reason？Let's talk about it。不客气，不客气。这个不客气，the three character both can separate 啊，不客气，不客气，let's see 哈，不客气，不客气，right where, right here，不客气，这个计算不 is second time is better 哈，不计算不，这个不客气，这个不 means no, not。气 here you can think is 气氛，气氛 is a Chinese word 哈，气氛 means atmosphere，气氛，气氛，对吧？Somebody is read as 气氛，对吧？Not important，气氛，这个气氛 is atmosphere。Let me put here，气氛，气氛哈，气氛 is atmosphere。即使气，you can think the meaning is atmosphere。客 means 客人，do you know 客人 what's meaning？客人，客人，客人，客人，客人 is guest 哈，客人 is guest。So 不客气，Can you understand the real Chinese logic? Real Chinese logic，客不客气，What's the meaning? Let's see right here, right here 吧，right here。客人，这个客人 means guest，气氛，气氛 means atmosphere。So here, 客 means guest, 氛 means atmosphere. So 不客气 means you not need to make the atmosphere like a guest. So 不客气 means you not need to treat yourself as a guest. You not need to do the manner of guest. So means you are my friend, you are my family, you are my brother. So you are not a guest. So you not need to be so polite. So 不客气 means you are welcome. Understand? This is the reason why 不客气 means you are welcome. 好 I think most of you don't know this one, right? The deep logic of Chinese. And here, 你是哪国人？Oh, why no person answer me this question? 好，这个 What is you 是这个我是美国人 ，and I think I answer. 好 ，and here, 美国人 can be translated to American. Yeah, 美国人 yeah, 美国人 can translate to American. And the Chinese logic is a USA person, 对吧 ？USA person. And thank you. And oh, one person answer me. Good.这个 yeah, so I give you more questions to answer me. 你是哪国人 ？Maybe somebody don't want to answer me. 好 ，I give you more questions and you can answer me in the comments 啊。你是哪国人 ？And next one is 你喜欢吃什么水果？你 because the fruit and the country name, all of these in my shorts. I have a lot of shorts video.In the short video, I talk about that. So if you watch some of them, now we can do the test. You can say it or not. 你喜欢吃什么水果? What's the meaning? 你喜欢吃什么水果? 这个你是哪国人? Translate to English is what country are you from? Where are you from? What, C-O-U-N-T-R-Y, country.U-F-R-O-N, are you from? 对吧? What country are you from? 哎呦, here. What country are you from? 你是哪国人? What country are you from? And 你最喜欢吃什么水果? Another question for you. 你最喜欢吃什么水果? Do you know the meaning? 你最喜欢吃什么水果? Here. Delete the meaning first. 你 means you, 喜欢 means like.啊、你喜欢吃什么水果？吃 means eat， 什么 means what， 水果 means fruit， 对吧？also can say 你最喜欢吃什么水果哈？最 do you know the meaning？ 最，你最喜欢吃什么水果？最 means most， so 你最喜欢吃什么水果 ？means which fruit you like most， 对吧？你最喜欢吃什么水果？你最喜欢吃什么水果？这个你最喜欢吃什么水果哈？这个 you most like to eat which fruit？ 好，这个你最喜欢吃什么水果 ？Yeah, Justin， 你喜欢吃什么水果 ？Also, okay. What fruit do you like？ 你喜欢吃什么水果？哎呦 ，What's this？ 好 ，And another question 哈 ，Another question， 你最喜欢什么颜色？你最喜欢什么颜色 ？Because in my shorts also talking about colors。你最喜欢什么颜色？你最喜欢什么颜色 ？Yeah, all of this is question for you, huh? Question for you. Because if you watch my shorts, you learn most of the colors, the fruits, the country names. You can try it in Chinese. You type in Chinese or Chinese pinyin. If you don't know, you can write English. 这个 let's see here. 计算。你最喜欢什么颜色 ？What's your favorite color？ 最 means most， 喜欢 means like， 对吧？你最喜欢什么颜色？颜色 means color 哈，颜色 means color。你最喜欢吃什么水果？你是哪国人 ？Yeah, three questions for you, and you can answer in the comments. And let's see this one. 我是菲律宾人。好 ，Your country name in Chinese we say 菲律宾，菲律宾。菲律宾哈，菲律宾，菲律宾。I think also voice translation, voice translation. 菲律宾 ，Philippines. Sound similar, right? 菲律宾 ，That's right here. 菲律宾，对吧？菲律宾哈，菲律宾。这个我喜欢吃绿色的葡萄。Very good. 你的中文很好，你的中文很好，对吧？你的中文很好。这个你的中文很好。我最喜欢橙色的。Here something is wrong, huh? 这个 I explain for you. 这个我最喜欢橙色。这个 you cannot say 的, huh? Because 橙色 the, the the is make something as adjective. That's right here. 这个 this is 菲律宾 and 橙色 the 这个 the make something as adjective, adjective. So when you say I like orange color, you cannot say I like adjective word. Understand? It's the same as in English, which one can be I cannot make an English example. But when you say I like orange, that orange is known, right? I like O-R-A-N-G-E, orange. I like orange. The orange is the orange is how to say? It's known. Understand? This is about grammar, huh? So this word in English, the adjective and the noun of orange is same. But in Chinese, not. In Chinese, 橙色橙色 means the color, means orange color, 对吧？橙色的 means the orange thing, the adjective. Understand? 橙色 is known, orange color. So you should say, 我最喜欢橙色 That's correct. You say, 我最喜欢橙色的 is wrong. Understand? 计算，我最，哎呦，我最喜欢橙色，对吧？我最喜欢橙色 I most like orange color, 对吧 I most like orange color. 这个 this one. 哎 why these three characters no person answer me? 你是哪国人你喜欢吃什么水果你最喜欢什么颜色 What's your favorite color? What fruit do you like? And what country are you from? If you don't know Chinese, you can type English. And I will teach you how to say in Chinese, 对吧 so next question, give you one more question to make you answer me.你的爱好是什么？你的 seems like all of that three questions you some of you you're not curious, so I'll give you another question. 你的爱好是什么？你的爱好是什么？对吧？你的爱好是什么 ？I think only 爱好 the word a little bit difficult. 爱好 means hobby 哈，爱好 means hobby.你的爱好是什么？你的爱好是什么 ？Your hobby is what? Here, what's your hobby? 这个爱好 means hobby, 是 means is, 什么 means what? The translate to of is okay. The in English you can translate to of, you can translate to this one possession, 对吧 ？The is a Chinese thing to make something as a adjective. 你的 means belong to you, 对吧？你的 is describing. The in Chinese meaning is describing. D-E-S.C-R-I-B-I-N-D describing 哈，你的爱好，爱好 is hobby， 所以 how to describe the hobby？ What hobby is your hobby？ So it's describing. The in Chinese meaning is describing. Translate to English, you can translate to of, translate to 计算 that size 对吧 ？Possession 好，这个你的爱好是什么 ？What's your hobby？ 这个好 ，go on continue 计算。非常有趣的老师哈 very good 谢谢你谢谢你谢谢你非常有趣的老师 the meaning is a very interesting teacher 哈非常 is very 有趣 is interesting 老师 is teacher 这个好 I see some comments and after I read all of the comments we end this lesson 哈这个 because now is more than one hour and 非常有趣的老师 very interesting teacher 非常 Mrs.Very means very very 对吧？有趣 means interesting interesting 有趣的 interesting 老师老师 teacher and the is not needed 啊、yeah yeah the is not needed 这个 because the makes something as adjective so the sentence 我最喜欢橙色的 is wrong you should say 我最喜欢橙色哈 good 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 计算 Do you like mango? I like it 对吧 ？Mango 对吧 ？Mango in Chinese do you say?芒果，芒果，芒果 is mango 哈，芒果，芒果 I think is what's translated right? 芒果 ，mango， 芒果 ，mango， 对吧 ？So it's what's translated from English. So I guess 哈 ，I guess from the word, long time ago in China didn't have mango. So the mango is came from foreign country and we translated to 芒果，芒果，对吧？果 in Chinese means fruit, 芒果 means mango, 果 means fruit 啊，苹果对吧？苹果 is apple.果 means fruit, 水果水果 is the real word for fruit, 水 means water, 对吧水果水果 is two characters for fruit, You just say one character 果 means the result of some plant, 对吧？苹果 apple, 芒果 mango. 我是 Colombia. This is Colombia. 这个哥伦比亚 right? 哥伦比亚哥伦比亚对吧？哥伦比亚几点了？哥伦比亚几点了？这个哥伦比亚哈 ，Let's write here. 哥伦比亚，哥伦比亚 ，Repeat after me. 哥伦比亚，哥伦比亚哈，哥伦比亚，亚 should be first time 哈。哥伦比亚，好，哥伦比亚 ，Welcome you， 欢迎你，欢迎你，哥伦比亚，哥伦比亚。好 ，Colombia and 计算。我喜欢吃苹果啊 ，very good, very good。我喜欢吃苹果。这个我在 Colombia 啊 ，very good。我在 ，I'm in， 对吧？我在哥伦比亚 and here。我的爱好是做作业。very interesting answer 哈 ，very interesting answer。我的爱好是做作业 ，the meaning。我的爱好是做作业，计算 ，I type it。我的爱好是做作业哈，计算 very interesting。我的爱好是做作业，做是 do 哈，做是 do。这个作业，作业是 homework。作业，我的爱好是做作业，很好的爱好，很好的爱好。这个我的爱好是做作业，计算 let's top here。这个我的爱好是做作业，我 is I。的 is possession, so 我的 together means my 哈，我的 together means my 爱好 hobby 是 means is 做 means do 作业 means homework 我的爱好是做作业，好 very good hobby 我的爱好是做作业 and yeah no more comments so today our lesson will end.And see you next time. See you next time. I tell you how to say in Chinese. See you next time. 这个下次见，对吧？下次见。下次 is next time. 见是 see， 对吧？下次见。下次，哎 ，where is my sentence here？ 好，下次见哈。下次是 next time， 见是 see， 下次见，对吧？In Chinese goodbye， you have two way to say， one is bye bye， 对吧？bye bye is similar to English， another way is 再见，对吧？再见， so 再见再 means again 哈，见 means see， so 再见 literal meaning means again see you again， 对吧？ see you next time， see you again， so 下次见 next time see you， 对吧？ see you next time， and 再见 is bye bye， 对吧？ bye bye goodbye， 对吧？好。计算再见，计算下次见 ，very good， you learned it， 下次见 ，and 谢谢老师 ，thank you teacher， 不客气，对吧？这个再见老师，这个 teacher goodbye， 对吧？好，大家再见，大家 is everyone 哈，大家再见，拜拜 ，see you next time， 下次见，再见。